Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, I am going to demonstrate and describe about the temperature process control system. By this system, students and one can learn about how the temperature processing works in the industrial environment. In this setup, we have introduced different data analog and input and digital inputs and outputs provided, and we are also using a PID control of the temperature. In the precisely designed a heating chamber in which we have connected the temperature sensors like thermocouples, RTD, different type of sensors, and then we measure the temperatures through the PID controller and also the DAQ system. So this is the complete setup here. I will describe whole setup by one, explaining about the all modules which are installed in this with. And also we will explain about the different temperature sensors and the different heating chambers, all the heating of the heating chambers that we have designed especially for this purpose. So before that, I will give you the order code. The order code for this system is 192.0.4.2.4.6.6. So by this order code, you can query about the system to check the different specifications and to order this and to purchase this whole system of temperature processing measurement. So I will explain you about the old modules one by one. So we will start with the single phase power supply panel, as the whole system works on the 230 volt AC power supply. In this, we are using a two pole MCB of 4 ampere and a bidirectional multifunction meter in which we can get the supply mains voltages, amperes and frequencies. All the different parameters can be get from this multifunction meter. There is a power LED or the pilot lamp provided. When we on the power, this green LED will be glowing. And the 230 volt AC power supply sources by which we can forward the supply to other panels. Now moving on, this is a digital control meter panel. In this panel also works on the 230 volt AC power supply, and the 224 volt DC input supply are also provided with this. So this is the AC power supply provided to this panel, and also from forwarded supply from the single phase supply panel is provided. In this, we can use the PID controller is already installed in this digital control meter panel, in which we can provide the different inputs like thermocouple, RTD. Also we can provide the current range input or the analog inputs, or the digital output from this PID controller can be get from these terminals. This is the digital control output 1, and this is the digital control output 2, and this is the PC interface cable also connected with this to conclude and connect the PC interface with the HMI and the other functions. So this is also working with the 24 volt supply. The 24 volt supply can also be provided and extruded. So this is a whole section of PID control section, the potential integral differential controller. So we can measure the temperature in the PID control mode, and we will control the process through this controller in the PID mode. So this is the digital control meter panel here. In this, we can control the also works on the 230 volt AC power supply with the 24 volt DC input supply. In this, there is a K-type temperature meter. This is for the K-type thermocouple temperature meter. In this, we can measure the temperature of thermocouple in the K type, and there is a RTD temperature meter also. In this, the RTD input should be provided at this terminal. We can measure the value by output of the RTD. Also we have to provide the DC supply for all the systems in the both blocks, and the AC supply is forwarded through the other modules. Now moving on, this is the DAQ panel. We will move to the DAQ panel. In this DAQ panel, the panel works on the 230 volt AC power supply. By this, the DC power supply can be distributed via these terminals, and this is the DAQ module. In this, the input digital inputs are provided here. So this works on the built-in 232 RS232 and 485 ports compatible with the Modbus ASCII RTU protocols, and 8 nodes of digital inputs and 8 nodes of digital outputs are provided with this DAQ module, and 9 nodes of analog input and PC and HMI interface are also provided. So moving on to the HMI panel. In this HMI panel, we are using a HMI of 7 inches, which is a TFT LCD with the 65 amp colors. and user memory of this HMI is 128 MB flash plus 64 MB DRAM, and data logging is inbuilt up to 1 lakh logs, and display configuration is a 7 inch resistive touchscreen with IP68 protection. Communication serial port are RS485 for COM1 and RS232 RS485 for COM2, and USB port also provided with this HMI at this right hand side surface. And also the supply voltage for this HMI is 24 volt supply that we have provided here to power on the HMI. And this is the DAQ interface with the DAQ module. So this is the HMI at which we can see the different functioning of the meter readings while working with the DAQ control. Now moving on, input output panel here. In this we have the three different inputs for start, stop the process and heater input and the fan input to providing the DAQ module, and there are the indication outputs. In this there are all the lamps and the alarm here already installed inside. So these are the output terminals which will be connected with the DAQ module. So this is the process status, alarm status, heater lamp and the fan lamp. When any one of the working the lamp will be showing indications, and there is a SSR relay provided to control these sections. The output will be controlled with the DAQ module. So these are the SSR relays output that is connected with the sensors that we have provided on the heater chamber. Now moving on, this is the temperature transmitter panel. In this transmitter panel we have a 24 volt power supply at which these transmitters are working, and there are two type of transmitter are installed for the RTD transmitter and the thermocouple transmitter. When we provide the thermocouple output on these terminals, the output in the analog or the digit 0 to 4 to 20 milliamps current output will be provided from T3 and T4 terminal, and that will be goes to the PID controller by which we can measure the value and control the output. And also similar for the thermocouple transmitter, when provided the thermocouple at this terminal, the output in the current measurement will be provided from 4 to 20 milliamps in the PID controller, or as well as to see and display the output or the for the digital control meter panel also. Now moving on, this is the sensor panel here at which we have connected four different types of sensor. These sensor cables are coming from the heater chamber. Here we have connected a K-type sensor, a K-type other sensor or the thermocouple, and a PT100 sensor for RTD, and another PT100 sensor for RTD. We have connected two nodes of all the sensors, and sensors output can be also taken from these terminals to any of the module by controlling the DAQ panel or by controlling the digital control meter panel. All the sensors can be taken output from these terminals. Now moving on to the heater chamber. So this is the heater chamber specially designed for this process control, the temperature process control. In this there is a K-type thermocouple installed and the RTD PT100 for the same measurement of nearby temperatures. Similar, there is another K-type thermocouple, and in continuation where there is a RTD also connected. All the terminals are connected with the sensor input panel, and this is the heater chamber. Heater is installed inside this heater chamber, and it is a different at we can measure the different temperatures at the different sections and the different positions of the heater chamber. So we have connected all the two of the K-type thermocouple and two of the RTD in the chamber, and there is an analog temperature gauge also provided by which we can see the actual temperature analog in the meter. Right now you can see the temperature showing at the temperature gauge is about 30 degrees. So this is about the room temperature right now. We will also verify and calculate this temperature by the DAQ module and the PID module also. We have also provided a fan and outside the chamber. This fan provides the proper air input when we off the heater to cooling too frequently and too fastly cooling down the heater chamber. So we will observe the cooling and heating process in both the conditions. We are also providing a user manual for detailed study of all the components provided on this panel and to detail study the temperature process control system and you can also perform all the experiments provided in the user manual. The whole frame is all the system is installed and mounted with the rivet frame of this is the movable frame with the wheels provided inside this workbench. You can easily port it and this move this and displace this system by using and easily transform and transport this system to any of the places in your display. And this is the also compartment box in which there is the accessories can be easily placed. The whole all compartment of the AC accessories are provided with this pouch. In this we can place all the accessories with required with this kit in the single place, and in after working with the kit you can place the accessories, so the all accessory will not be lost. So before doing the experiments we will study the fixed connection wiring. The fixed connection wiring connections are already connected and already provided on the panel. So these are the fixed connection wiring table. In this the from is the section from where the terminals are connected with to the two is the other section, and also describe the power supply wiring. So these are the power supply wiring or the single phase power supply panel T1 T2 are connected with the digital control meter panel T10 T12. So also the display diagram from easy understanding are also provided on this. So these are the connection, these are the fixed connection, this should be remains same for all the practicals. Also we have already connected all the sensors here, so we do not need to connect the sensors while doing the sensor wiring in the experiments. So this is the meter settings and input tables for different ranges, in which we get when we use the K-type thermocouple the ranges from minimum to maximum are provided in this table also, and when we use the voltage supply. So we have to do the controlling and the parameter setting of the PID controller as per this manual and meter setting given in the user manual. Now these are the power on and different settings. These settings are already done for all the systems. Try do not change these settings for this. Already settings are done in the process control system or the temperature process control system. Now moving on to the first experiment, which is to study the working of thermocouple temperature sensor. In this we will study the working of thermocouple temperature sensor using a PID controller. We have to do the connections as described in the connection diagram, also in the connection table. For this we will do the connections which are except from the fixed connections. So these are the connections provided in the user connection diagram, and then after we will see how the PID control works and we will observe the readings by different times and actual temperature, and we will follow the procedure as described in the user manual. Now we will do the wiring as per the circuit diagram and as per the circuit table given in the user manual. So we will first connect the digital control meter wiring. So for this we will first connect the digital control meter panel's T7 terminal. So this is the digital control meter panel. Now we will connect the T7 terminal with the input output panel of T13. This is the T13 here. Also we will connect the T9 terminal of the digital control meter. So this is the T9 terminal and this will be connected with the terminal number 14. So what we have done here is we have connected the digital control outputs from the PID controller to one output will be connected with the heater and other output will be connected with the fan. So as we set the temperature value, the outputs will be work as the behavior required, whether it to rise the temperature or whether it's to cool the temperature. Now we will connect the digital control meter panel T4 with the sensor panel T1. So we have to include the sensors. For this we will connect the T4 terminal of the digital panel, control meter. Now we will connect this with the thermocouple first. This is the T1 terminal of the sensor panel, and we will connect the T4 with the T2 terminal of this sensor control panel. Now for the sensor wiring, we have already done the sensor wiring, that we have connect the sensor panel sensor 1 from the thermocouple K type. This is the sensor 1, thermocouple K type is already connected here, and heater chamber wiring is also done, that we have connected the heater red and black on the SSR relays. So these are the heater red and black on the terminal T7 and T8, and the T9 and T10 fan terminal are also connected with these relays. Now just we have to do the settings as per the procedure, and we will study the process control accordingly. So now first we will on the single phase MCB. Here we will see the power LED lamp is pilot lamp is glowing. This will show the output, and other equipments are right now working on its way. Now we will only do work as we required on the digital control meter panel. Now we have to set the input type in the PID controller. For this we have to select the K type thermocouple in the input type. So for doing this, we will first press the mode key for 2 seconds, and we will reach the programming with the parameter. Now we will go with the parameter 3 and press mode. In this we have select the input type as the K type thermocouple. For K type thermocouple, the abbreviations are also given in the user manual. You can do this by your own, by studying the manual of the thermocouple. So this is the K type thermocouple symbol that I have selecting here. Now press mode. So we have selected the K type thermocouple. Here as I selected the K type thermocouple, fan is going started, and the temperature of the heater chamber is showing at the PID controller right now. Now this is the set value. Set the red one is the actual value or actual temperature showing at the digital control panel. So now we will connect the and we will set the values, which is the set value. Now output 2 is on at this time. You can see as the temperature set is 0 right now, which is the higher, which is not the set value accordingly. So fan is on, fan temperature, actual temperature is higher from the set value. That's why that fan is working and try to cool the temperature, but in the ideal conditions temperature cannot be 0 degree. So we will increase the temperature by changing this. So we will increase the temperature about 40 degrees for the experiment purpose. And as I select the temperature about 40 degree, the hysteresis working starts and heater will working starts. Now you can see output 1 is started and heater is on. Also the symbol or the pilot lamp of the heater is glowing. That shows the relay of heater is on and heater is working on the heating mode. You also observe the voltages on the multifunction meter at this time. So that the load of the heater is showing at the multifunction meter. So you can see the load is 5.9 ampere right now. Voltage is in 220 volts. So heater is working, and as the temperature increases, the heater will close on and off accordingly to the PID control. So we will wait the heater. At this time you will observe the temperature, actual temperature in different steps, and how the temperature increases. You will also observe the time taken to increase the temperature to the set values. So you can also measure the actual temperature on the heating chamber. The heating chamber is showing the actual temperature is about 32 degrees right now. So similar temperature is also showing at the PID controller, you can see. And this will also rise as the heater starts working in the PID mode. You can see the temperature is 33 degree in the PID meter. As the heater is working, the temperature starts rising slowly. So the heater will on and off frequently till the set values does not reach, and at this time you can observe the time taken to the reaching chamber to reaching the set values, and you can observe and note down the time and actual temperatures from zero, so from actual the room temperature, which is the 30 degree, to the set value that we have set it here for 41. You can do the temperature on different temperature settings. You can also do the experiment on 60 degree, 70 degree and 80 degrees on the different temperature settings. You can measure and do the note the readings as per the requirements. Now you can see the temperature is rising very fastly. So as the temperature reaches the set values, this will off the heater and the fan will be starts working. So this is the PID control process of the temperature. Here you can see temperature is right now about 39.4, and we have set the values, the set temperature is 41. As the temperature 41 reaches, this will off the heater and starts the lamp. Here you can see temperature is almost reaching 41. Now as the temperature goes far and above from the set values, after some time, here you can see the fan is started, and this will take to some time to on and off the fan. Fan is one time start, and as the temperature reaches more farther than the set values, then the fan will be on for more time. Now you can note down all the readings at different temperatures and plot the graph with actual temperature and time at the observation table. After resulting, you will understand the process control through the PID controller. Now we will do the K-type thermocouple temperature measurement using temperature meter. For this, we will just connect the digital meter wiring from sensor T1, T2. These are the sensor output will be connected with the digital meter panel of T5, T6. So we will see the temperature. Now we will do these connections, where you can see after PID controller working, the temperature is highest going to the 60 degrees, and now it is decreasing by the fan. And at this time, now we will observe the current from the digital control meter and the temperature meter. For this, the sensor output that we have provided on the PID controller, for this we will open this sensor wires. The T1 sensor will be connected with the T5 of the K-type temperature meter, and T2 will be connected with the T6. So the actual temperature will also show on the temperature meter. So this is the temperature meter. Now that as we remove the sensor wires from the PID controller, so the PID process has now been stopped, and the temperature, actual temperature, is showing at this meter. Now the temperature will automatically cool down without the fan, and this will show the changes of the temperature also. Now we will do the experiment number 2 given in the user manual. For this, we will study the working of RTD PT100 temperature sensor. The RTD is the resistance temperature detector. It's frequently used in the industrial purposes also. Thermocouple also used in the industrial purposes. So this is the wiring descriptions given in the table also. So we have to connect the digital control meter panel T7, T9, T3, T4, T5 frequently with the input output panel T13, 14, T5, 6 and 7. So we have already connected the output and input terminals as in the last experiment. So now we will only add the RTD sensor to the temperatures. So we will first turn off the MCB off right now working, and we will change the sensor inputs. So we will connect the sensor wires accordingly as given in the user manual. So for this we will connect the T5, the RTD sensors terminals, to the T3 of the PID controller. Here now we will connect the T6 with the T4 of the PID controller, and T7 of the RTD sensors third wire will be connected with the T5 of the PID controller. Similarly, as we have selected the thermocouple input, we also have to select the RTD input as the input sections, and the output wire already connected as per the last experiment. Also, the sensor and heater and fan connections are remain same. They are already connected, inbuilted, so you do not need to change the connections and to do the connections again and again. So this is the easy process. Now we will on the MCB and now we will change the mode to the RTD. So we'll go to parameter 3 and change the input terminals as DP TH given in the user manual. So we will select the RTD. So this is the DPTH, the RTD input. Now we will go to home screen. Here you can see the set value is again 0 as we have changed the input, and the actual value is 52 degree showing at the chamber's output. Now we will set this value again to 60 degree to seeing the working of PID control. So that's we have set the 60 degree. Now the set value is higher than the actual value. So now in some time heater will be started working. We will wait for the heater to be start. As the output 1 will be start, the heater will start working. Here you can see output 1 has been started and heater starts working and heating up the chamber temperature. The pilot indication of the heater is also showing. So the temperature will slowly increase and then the heater will working in slow times, and as the temperature is right now 10 degrees farther than the set points, so the heater will working in the height for the more time, and as the temperature reaches closest to the set value, so the heater will work for the very fractions of time. So you can observe the actual temperature and actual time in the some of the different scales. You can observe the temperature in some of the 10 seconds scale, or in the 30 seconds, or in the 60 seconds scale. So how the temperature will work. So this is about we do the RTD sensor. You can do the different values. You can do that same experiment on different temperature values and note down the actual temperature readings. For the similar output, we will also do the RTD input measurement through the temperature meter also. For this, here you can see the temperature started rising. This is the temperature process. This will take its own time to rising the temperature. Now we will see the temperature meter of the RTD. For this we will turn off the MCB and change this terminal to the RTD temperature meter. Always remember the proper connections as described in the user manual. Now we will turn on the MCB again. This meter is the RTD temperature meter that is already calibrated and programmed accordingly. So the temperature of actual temperature right now of the chamber is showing at this temperature meter. So this is the RTD temperature meter which is showing the temperature. So you can do all the experiments as described in the user manual for the different temperature readings with the temperature meter and digital PID control meter. Now we will do the experiment number 3, which is to study the controlling of temperature using DAQ and HMI. So DAQ is the data acquisition control panel which I have installed in this. So we will do the HMI and DAQ control. This is the right now requirement of the industries. So one can study the DAQ modules and programmings of the HMI and how these modules work in the industrial purposes. So this is the wiring diagram and wiring table is given in the user manual. So these are the input output wiring. So we will connect the digital inputs and analog digital outputs for the DAQ modules from the input output panel to provide the digital inputs manually, and as well as from the HMI also. And for the DAQ panel, this is the DAQ panel in which we have connected the DAQ system already installed and already programmed as per the process. And also the DAQ wiring for the analog outputs and analog inputs are given as per describing. So now we will do the whole wiring. Also the wiring diagram for the DAQ system is given as per the visual method also, and this is the tabular method. So we will follow the procedure to do the DAQ experiment. Now we will do the wiring as per the user manual. For DAQ wiring, we will start with the wiring the digital inputs outputs. So this is the input output wiring. Now we will connect one by one input. So input output terminal T3, so this is the T3, will be connected with the T11 of the DAQ panel, and T4, this is the stop input, will be going to the T12 of the DAQ panel, and T5, which is the heater input panel, will be connected with the T13, and the last input of the fan input will be connected with the T14. So that we have provided the 4 digital inputs. Now the output will be connected. So we will connect the output digital outputs from the DAQ panel. For this we will connect the T11 indicator output for the process status with the output T27. The second output of alarm output will be connected with the T28, the DO1 of the DAQ module. Also the heater output that will operate the heater accordingly the temperature, the T29 will be third output, or DO2, and T14 is the last output, which is the fan output. This will be connected with the T30 terminal. Now we will do the DAQ wiring accordingly. For this we will connect the DAQ panel T19, 20 with the sensor panel T5 and T6. So we will connect T19 and T20 So this is the T19AI0, the analog input. This will be connected with the T5 of the sensor. So we will use the RTD sensor to controlling this process, and also all the other 3 sensors will also be connected, but this will only show the temperature. The controlling will be done with the only RDT temperature. So T20 will be connected with the T6 of the RTD, and the last one T7 will be connected with the T21. So now T7 will be connected with the T35. So these are the RTD inputs that has been connected. Now we will connect T21 other sensor to just seeing the value. So T21
will be connected with the T4. So this is the T4, and T22 will be connected with the T3 of the sensor panel. So T22 will be connected with the T3. So that we have connected the thermocouple here. Now we will connect the T23 and T24. These are the AI inputs of the DIQ module with the transmitter panel T3 and T8. So in this we will use the transmitter panels. So we will connect the T23. This is the T23 or the AI4 of the DIQ module. This will be connected with the transmitter panel T3. So this is the temperature transmitter panel. This will be connected with T3. And T24, the DIQ module. So this will be also connected with the T8. So these are the input of the transmitter panel. Sorry, the output from the transmitter panel. Now we will connect the sensors to these transmitters input. For this temperature transmitter wiring, we will do the wiring as per the circuit. So we will connect first RTD to the transmitter panel. So this is the RTD transmitter. Now we will connect the other RTD, T8, with the T5. And T9, T10 will be connected with the T6 and T7 in the respective terminals. So this is the T9 connected with T6, and T10 connected with T7. So that we have given RTD input to the transmitter, and the transmitter output will be input AI input to the module. So module will show the temperature on the HMI. Now we will connect the thermocouple to the transmitter. For this we will connect the T1 with the T1 input, T10 input of the transmitter, and T2 will be connected with the T11. So T2 of the sensor panel will be connected with the T11, so that we have given the thermocouple input to the transmitter also, and the output of the transmitter is the converted 4-20 milliamps output that been given to the analog input of the DIQ module. So these are all the connections. Sensor wirings and the heater and fan wirings are already done, that we do not have to change. Also the relay wiring of the fan and heater are also connected. Now we will follow the procedure of the user manual. So we have already on the value. Now you can see the temperatures at the HMI of all the different sensors are showing in this display. Here you can see RTD1 68 degrees, thermocouple 1 is giving 64.9. So the temperature of the chamber is slightly different at some different positions, and the output, this is the transmitted output of 4-20 from the RTD2 is 66, which is almost equal to the RTD1, and thermocoupled output is 59.6. So this is the extreme output, near to the fan. So this is the more cooled area of the temperature chamber. Now we will start the process by pressing the start or touching the start here. So here you can see status is showing at the HMI is the start. Also the status will showing at the input output panel. The lamp of the indicator output is also showing that the process has been started. Now we will start the heater from the now we can change the setting range by this options. Now the set point is 45 degree already setted, so we can change this set points by going to the settings. In this settings, do not change the minimum maximum range, just change the set point. Now we can change the set point about 65 degree and press enter. So 65 is the set point. As I set the point, the fan stops working and heater starts working. As the RTD input is 63 right now, so this will increase the temperature till 65 degree. Now we will go to the home screen. At this time we can also see the control functions given at the HMI. So this is the process control which is showing whole purposes. Now at this time you can see the heater indication is on at the HMI, and as well as the on the heater lamp in the input output panel is also on. So this will indicate the heater is working. And now we will go to the display setting module. Here you can see the chamber and the representation is showing that the value is the heating value is 63.6 and actual temperature is increasing and heater is on right now. Now we will go to the home screen. And the actual temperature are showing. You can also observe the graphical representation by pressing this icon. So as I press this icon, you can see the graphical representation is showing. In this, all the values are given. So red line of the graph is showing the RTD value 4 to 20 milliamps, and red line is showing the set point. So the set point is almost nearby to the actual temperatures, and this graph is showing the 1x1 settings of per second output of the temperatures. So all the readings are right now nearby, that's why all the graphs is almost equal. And as the temperature goes farther than the set point, the values remaining from all the RTDs will increase the red line in this graph. Here you can see the temperature has been crossed the 65.6 value, which is the temperature set value is 65. So as the temperature reaches to 65 or cross the 65 degrees temperature, the fan is started in working. Now you can see on the overlay diagram also, here you can see the fan is working. This will showing the HMIs. Now on the graphical representation, you can also observe at the last end of the graphical representation, in the last seconds the temperature crosses the set values, and now it will decreasing as the fan starts working. So this is how we do the process control by the DIQ panel and DIQ module. You can also use the input outputs physically to control the panels. As I use the heater input from this push button, first we have to press the stop, and as I press the stop, the system will stop working and the indication of alarm will be buzzing from buzzer from the about 15 seconds, and after 15 seconds it will automatically goes off. Here you can see. And now I will start process from here also. You can see process status is also showing. Now as per the temperature, the heater will starts working, and as the required, it is if it is required cooling, the fan will starts, and if it is required heating according to the set temperature, then the heater will be start. So this is the whole programming and different methods of the DAQ control of RTD through the RTD sensor. You can also take the outputs from the measurement panel also. So we will go to the home screen. This is the home screen now, and at the USB port you can take the output, and by pressing the log button you can see all the time and all the different temperatures collected by the temperature sensors are also showing with the time settings. Now when we press this module, you can detect the output from the flash disk, and how to take the output from the module is also explained in the user manual. So you can take the output, and this will be converted in the CSV or PDF format, and that can be easily opened on your PCs. So we will go to home screen again and stop the process. This process can be stopped from here also. Here you can see buzzer is blowing, and this will stop in 15 seconds automatically. Now for the fourth experiment, we will study the working of PID controller to control temperature using temperature transmitter. So in earlier practical, while we using the PID controller directly, now we will use the PID controller through the temperature transmitter. So these are the wiring sections and wiring table given in the user manual already. So we will do the wiring as per the user manual. So similarly, we will connect the output from the relay output of the PID controller, then the sensor output will be first given to the transmitter output, then the transmitter output from the current range will be provided to the PID controller, and we will change the input method through from thermocouples to the analog input, which is the 4 to 20 milliamps output, and we will also set the minimum and maximum range of the temperature according to the thermocouple temperature ranges. Now for this we will connect the output or the digital control output T7 terminal from the fan or the heater output, the output 1, and T9 terminal, the output 2, will be connected with the T4 terminal. This is the fan output. Now for providing the transmitter input, we will connect the fetch codes. First we will use the thermocouple, so we will connect the thermocouple T1. The T1 will be connected with T10, the thermocouple transmitter input, and T2, the thermocouple sensor output, will be connected with the transmitter input with the T11 terminal. Now the output or the transmitter output will be connected with the input of the 4 to 20 milliamps. So we will connect T8, the output of transmitter, thermocouple transmitter, with the T3 terminal, and T9, the thermocouple transmitter output's other terminal, will be connected with the T4 terminal. Now we will change the mode to the current as it is showing right now open. So we will change the mode, the input will be changed to the AI or the current analog input. So from the settings we will select AI A2. This is the 4 to 20 milliamp input. Now as I select this, the output will be showing. Now at this time we will also have to set the values accordingly the table that I have explained in the user manual. So now that we have set the analog output is 4 to 20 milliampere AI A2 here from the table. Now we will connect, as we have connected the K-type thermocouple from here, so for this range, we have to set the minimum and maximum temperature ranges from 199- to +999.9 to see the proper temperature output.
So we will set the range on the PID controller. So we will go to parameter 3 sections, and this will remain for A1, A2. Press mode. So this is the lower input, which is the 4 milliamps, and this is the higher input, 20 milliamps. Now we will change the dot to 0.02. This remains same. And for this setting, we will set the lower scale. So the lower scale will be the 199. So we will be set this to 199. This is the lowest range that the thermocouple can withstand and working proper accuracy. So this is the value. Now for higher settings, we will set this value from higher. So this higher settings will be from 9992. So this will be 999. Yeah, you can see. So these are the value that have been set. Now we will go to the home screen. Here you can see the actual temperature, 60 degree will showing from the thermocouple, and you can set the temperature accordingly as the earlier practical and do the readings by measurement of the actual temperature with the time, and PID controller will work in the setting range. So we will set the range to 55 here. So the temperature will try to decrease accordingly, and fan will work, and after that the heater will start as the temperature reaches to the set value. So we will set the value right now. Actual temperature is 62, so we will set the value about nearby. So we will reach the value frequently. So I have set the setting set value about 58. So now fan will work and try to decrease the temperature till 58 degree, and after the temperature crosses the 58 degree value, this will start the heating process again. So heater will start and temperature will again rising. So that's how we use the transmitted output from the sensor in the industry, and you can do same practical as the using RTD sensor. In this, just we have to change the values. The analog input method will be same, just we have to change the temperature value according to the RTD temperature. Now for beef part, for we will now use the RTD PT100. For this, we will connect the RTD sensor's output as the transmitter's input, and the transmitted output will be connected with the RTD for the PID controller. So we will connect the T5 with T5 for the RTD transmitter, T6 with the T6, T7 with T7. Now the output of the transmitter will be connected in the same way as we have connected the thermocouple. So T3 will connected with T3, and T4 will connected with T4. Now you can see as the input method is already set to the analog input. So PID controller has already set the values accordingly, but we have to change the temperatures for the RTD sensor. So in this we are using DPT100, so PT100 ohm RTD from 0.1 decimal point. So we have to set the range from -200 to +650 degree, then we get the actual temperature value.
So we will go to the settings, parameter settings of the PID controller. Press parameter 3, press mod. AIA2 is the same current output from the transmitter. Minimum is 4, maximum is 20. Now we will set, it's -199. This is already done. Now we have to set this value to 650. So we will change this value to 6, and this will be 5, and this will be 0. So this is the value. Press mode, settings has been done. Now we will go back to home screen, and this will showing the actual temperature of the temperature chamber. For different ranges we can set the value as per according to the RTD and do the practical. So the output calculations can be done accordingly. This is also explained in the user manual. You can see the output of the temperature transmitter is 4 to 20 milliamps. So the minimum value is 4 amperes and the maximum value is 20, and the span is 20 minus 4 is 16, and PID controller temperature value is 0 to 100% and minimum value is 0 and maximum value is 100. So span will be 100. So this will be going 1 milliamperes, 6.25% of the PID controller. So that's how you calculate the values and put them into the observation table accordingly. All the calculations and formulas are given in the user manual. You can do the practicals for different set values from 60, 70, 80 and 90 degrees and plot the graph between actual temperature and time. So thus we have studied the working of PID controller to control temperature using temperature transmitter. So this is how I explained the and demonstrate the temperature process control system of Tesca. You can do all the experiments given in the user manual as described in the user manual and also as described in this video also. So while doing the experiments with this DAQ module and different HMI sections, you can also do the output and you can also take the reports or the data logging from this HMI. The USB port is provided here out in the left side of the DAQ HMI, so you can generate the reports from the USB output also. So while doing the experiments and while studying the manual and with any of the module, if you find difficulties while working with this kit, you can contact Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all the support. Thank you.